Hi, my name is Linda, and I'm the manager of the Kids Department here at Greenwood Public Library. Welcome. This is Full Steam Ahead, where we have lots of fun with activities and experiments all to do with STEAM, science, technology, engineering, art, and math. And today we are doing some more fun art stuff. So we are making pulled string art. I've been wanting to do this for a while, so thanks for playing along. You can see some of my first attempts here. Okay, I like that I'm black as well. This was a multi. Very easy to do, little bit messy. So if you're going to do this, I would say definitely have a table covering. You can see I have an apron on, have a cover up or old clothes. We will be using washable tempera paint for this. I know that there are ways you can use regular paint, you can use oil paint, you can use watercolors and even ink. I've seen a number of varieties of medium that you can use for this project, but we are going to use the washable tempera paint. Okay, let me put my samples over here and we will get started. So for this, you're going to need some tempera paint. You're going to need some paper. I'm using just plain like cardstock. I have some white and some black. I also do have some watercolor paper that I played with a little bit. So I pulled a couple of sheets of that. We'll try a couple of different ways of doing this. You're also going to need string. And you can use, this was just regular twine string, right? Like you just find at the hardware store. You can also use yarn, you can use small string, you can use the ball chains, different kinds of chains, whatever you want. And everything looks a little bit different. Like, so if you're using a bigger piece of yarn that might be stretchier too, it's going to give you a slightly different pattern than if you're just using a string like this. So it's a lot of fun to kind of mix and match. I actually also have some toothpicks and some craft sticks to help me manipulate the string when it's all full of paint. And as you can see, I've already put out I just kind of wanted to play around with some rainbow colors today. So I'm going to put some here in my plate and we'll play with that here in a minute. I also just put some out in different varieties. So I may not mix these. I may just do like one string will be yellow, one string will be red, and we'll try some things with that. I also have an old book, very appropriately, greeting cards and gift wrap. That was in my donate pile to Goodwill, and I rescued it out. And we're going to try using a book to help add some pressure as we do some pull a string through one of our pieces using that. All right, so the first thing we're going to do, I'm going to take my piece of paper here and I'm going to take one string and I am going to start laying it just kind of lay it right around my paint and I'm going to cover it. If you're using watercolor, you're going to want to probably wet your string. This is just a cotton string because I think it'll absorb better. This is tempera paint. So having it wet won't make any difference. But I do want to make sure that it's covered in paint to get the best effect, okay? And you can see that toothpick really comes in handy. And I know that you're like, oh, you're mixing the colors. Well, they're going to get mixed a little bit anyway. It's not a lot of mixing right through here. If I were doing like 50 of these, I probably would switch out my paint palette a little faster. But I think this will be fine. So let's get that good and covered. I always find it interesting that when we're working with tempera paints, they all have different viscosity. So like the red is really thin, the yellow is really thin. We get down to this bright pink and it's super thick and the green is thick. So I don't know what there is in the formulas, but some paint is probably gonna take a little bit more effort for you to work through. Let me put this, always be sure to put your painty sticks and toothpicks in a place where they don't touch like tables or anything else. So just put them, I have just a spare paper plate for trash and used toothpicks and stuff and string. All right, so I'm going to pick this up. All right, ooh, a lot of paint on that. And I am going to start just putting it on here. I think I'm going to make just, I like making little loops, just kind of fun designs. And you'll see I have paint already on my gloves. So by the way, I do have gloves on. This is washable, not a problem. I did this at home without gloves, but today it's just easier not to get as much paint all over the place since I don't have a sink right here. So if you have gloves, you may want to use them. Okay, so now I'm going to take another piece of paper. And I'm going to lay it right over the top. All right, and I'm just going to hold it. And I'm going to take my string, and I'm just going to pull it. All right, and I'm going to put that string right here, kind of like what I call my discard pile. Okay, and let's see. It's like a big surprise. You never know what you're going to get. Oh, I like the rainbow effect. That is very nice. When you do this particular design, it very often looks like, comes out looking like, I think, calla lilies and really pretty flowers, okay? So that's our first attempt, okay? Now I'm going to lay this to the side. Actually, because I use a top and a bottom, I have two. Move this out of our way so I can put our wet artwork over here. So let's try something on black paper. Okay, and we did that one already, so let's see what happens when we put a string. Let's try two or three things. Let's see, let's try blue, and I'm just going to kind of roll it, probably should put it over here where you can see it, roll it up right through here, okay, and I'm just going to take my toothpick and make it good and gooey. Now, let me try craft stick. Okay. All right. So there's one. Let's try green. I like that green. It's cheery. All right. And we'll do the same thing. Cover it. Ugh. I just noticed my craft stick has a little bit of a splinter on it. It's grabbing onto my string. Okay, there's one. Let's do another one. All right, I say yellow. Obviously, you could do as many colors or even repeat colors. If I wanted to do two blue strings, I could do that too. But let's see what we got. So I'm going to pull my yellow out. And drop it. Okay, very carefully lay that out. I think I'll take my blue next. I made really long strings. My paper is not that light. You can, and I just cut my paper in two, right? But obviously you can use entire big sheets. Oh. Okay, let's try the green. All right. Let's move this aside. I'm going to pull one at a time. Or should I do all three at once? I'll do one at a time. You could do all three at once. Okay, last one. Let's see. That looks more like a Rorschach test. All right. The nice thing about these, too, is when they dry, I mean, you could add more paint to them, obviously. And pick one that's dried. So, like this one, because this one obviously looks like a flower. I could actually go back with markers or with more paint. I probably would do paint. And I could add like leaves, butterflies, whatever I wanted to do. I could also go back and add, because this is dry now, I could actually do another string pull. Maybe I wanted to do something else, like right down here. I have this nice big space here and here. So I could fill it up and do more string pulls on this particular one if I wanted to. I know I did another one last night. I actually did three at one time, and this is what it turned out to be. But this one, I could actually go back and be way more intentional about my design. I like that. All right. This one actually looks like it has a blue wing butterfly on it. Well, let's try one with our book because we haven't done that yet. Okay. Let me get a string. Let's go back to this because I do like that rainbow effect. This time I'm going to start on the pink side. Because I notice that when I do this, I tend to probably drop my string at the top and start looping it from the top. You don't have to do that. You can drop it anywhere and go anywhere with it. But I notice that my designs often have like the white at the top now. So I'm going to do the, I'm going to do it backwards from what I was doing. Let's see what that looks like. Okay, that looks pretty good. All right, let me set that aside. I'm going to take, well, that is two pieces put together. I couldn't figure out why. This is what I was looking for. My watercolor paper is still attached. Okay, so I have a piece of, this is just cardstock. And I really, to be honest with you, I really like the way this is looking on cardstock. It's smooth. It seems to pull really well. We'll try one here in a minute with watercolor, and we can look at that. So I'm going to fold it. All right. And I'm going to put my paint string on it. And loop, loop, loop down. That out. I'm going to bring my book over and just slide it here in the middle. So I have my string here and I'm just going to pull. All right. And let's see what we got. That's worked. Now, you can see there's a lot more pressure than just when I'm using my hand, right? So this is a lot fuller, and there's actually a lot more paint actually left on the paper than when I'm just holding it with my hand. But I like that, too. And again, After this dries, I can go back, or I can not even wait, I can actually add detail as I want with paint as I go. Let's do one more because we haven't done watercolor paper yet, and I do want to try that. Okay, move this over. And apparently I like the rainbow one, but I do like all the different colors together. So let's do this real quick. Okay. See if watercolor paper makes a difference or holds it any differently. Try it with this. Try my hand. I like that best, I think. Looks nice. Okay, so that's on watercolor paint or watercolor paper. I do like that. This is the same design, the top part of it, just on cardstock. This actually, I know it's hard to see on camera. This has a little more texture to it, so it looks like it will dry, I think, just a little differently than it will on this paper. Well, that's really interesting. All right, well that. Is it for pull string art? I hope you have a fun time exploring and let us know if you how your creations turn out. I love these things that are open-ended. So don't forget to join us at the library. Go to www.greenwoodlibrary.us to keep up with what's going on in terms of programs and fun activities and all kinds of books and resources that we have. Plenty here to keep you occupied. And also I would invite you to come in and check out the arts and crafts section of the library, both in the kids' room and upstairs. We have a lot of wonderful activities that also go with painting and craft work. So if you have a need, just let us know. So thanks so much for joining us.